नमो नमः श्री हरये बुद्धिदाय दयावते भक्तिधर्मांगजाताय भक्तकल्पद्रुमाय च ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वं यत्किंच जगत्यां जगत् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जिथाः मा क्रुधः कस्य स्वेद्धनम् मुकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयते गिरीं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं सर्वे सुखिनः सन्तु सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय असतो मा सद्गमय सत्यं वद धर्मं चर मातृदेवो भव पितृदेवो भव आचार्य देवो भव अतिथि देवो भव ओम शांति ही शांति ही शांति ही।
Jai Swaminarayan. Dear students, many years ago, there was a great painter. He was so ambitious to make the unique paintings in the world. And people used to buy his paintings, paying millions of rupees. One day, he thought to make such painting which can reflect the glimpse of God in man. To make this painting, God in man, he began to search such person who is looking like a god. He traveled across so many cities, villages, but he couldn't find such person who has such divine appearance, merciful glow on his face, and such lovely nature. But one day, he could see one young man who was 16 years old. He could see that divinity on his face, that innocence, that merciful glow on his face. He came to that young man and he requested that, "Can you help me to prepare this painting, God in man?" That young man was so innocent and lovely. He said, "Yes, but what I have to do?" Painter said, "Nothing, you just sit in front of me." That young boy sat in front of painter, and painter made an amazing picture of God in man. When he published in public, people were amazed by seeing this amazing painting of God in man, and this painting sold out in a great price. After 10 years, once again this painter thought that, "Anyway, I have presented the glimpse of God in man to the world. Now I want to present a glimpse of devil in man." Once again he began to search such person who is looking like a devil. He went across so many villages, cities, but he couldn't find such person who is looking like devil. But one day He saw such a devil-like person who is completely violent and merciless. Anyway, this painter approached to him and humbly he requested to help him preparing this picture. That person anyway agreed to the painter. That devil-like person sat in front of painter and painter began to sketch. As he could finish the half picture, he could see the different expression on the face of that devil-like person. He could see the expression of regret. And meanwhile, that devil-like person began to cry. This painter was surprised. Painter came near to the devil and said that, "I'm sorry. Did I do any mistake? I'm extremely sorry for that." After a while, that person said to the painter, that, "Uncle, before 10 years, whom you had selected for the painting of God in man, and today, whom you have selected for the painting of devil in man, that person is same and he is none other than me." That painter was highly surprised. "Oh my God, how is that possible?" Then that person replied, "Due to company of bad friends, I got addicted to the alcohol, drugs, smoking, even adultery. I lost my study, my career, my family, my character. Now I am just living this miserable life." Anyway, this painter completed this painting, and this painting, Devil in Man, also sold out in a great price. Dear students, can you tell me why such a divine person turned into a devil person? What was the reason? And isn't this story relative to our lives? We see many children so good, innocent, positive in their childhood. But when they grow up, they turn bad. They get addicted to alcohol, drugs. Why? What is the root cause of this negative transformation? Dear students, let me remind you that in this world, there are different kinds of people around us, like good people, bad people, violent people, kindful people, selfish people, selfless people, addicted people, addiction-free people. What makes them so? There are two life-changing factors which influence our whole life. It can make our life and also break our life. Those two life-changing factors are food and friendship, ahar and vihar. For right food, we have discussed in our last video session, and today we will discuss about a right friendship. Dear students, today I would like to present one powerful analysis from Mahabharata. In Mahabharata, there were two great warriors, Arjun and Karna. Both were the star warriors, but one became winner, another became loser. One utilized his skills to protect Dharma, and another utilized his skills to protect Adharma. One fought for Lord Krishna, and another fought against Lord Krishna. Can you tell me what made them so? Both were having similar kinds of skills. What made the difference? Who directed their skills? Who directed their potential? Dear students, their friendship. The choice of their friendship determined their destiny and their future. When Karna was insulted by the society, when Karna was rejected by the people as a Sutputra, at that time, Duryodhan has respected him. Duryodhan has praised Karna as a brave warrior in front of everybody. Karna got over him and he dedicated himself to Duryodhan. Karna chose Duryodhan as his friend forever. While Arjun has dedicated himself to Lord Krishna. He chose Lord Krishna as his friend forever. Today my question to you is, are you having praising friends in your life or raising friends in your life? Are you having praising friends like Duryodhan, who praises to fulfill his selfish intention? Or are you having raising friends like Lord Krishna, who raises for Dharma and righteousness? Lord Krishna raised Arjun for the great mission of establishment of Dharma. while Duryodhan has praised Karna to favor Adharma. Whom you choose as your friend will determine your future, will determine your destiny. And someone said truly, that show me your friends, I will show you your future. Show me your friends, I will show you your future. If you have raising friends like Lord Krishna, you will become victorious and glorious like Arjuna. But if you will have praising friends like Duryodhan, then you will become a loser like Karna. You also are born with the great potential to be like Arjuna and to do extraordinary work in your life. But finally, the success of your potential depends on your company, on your friendship. Dear students, now you may have question that what is called friendship? Generally, people say that friendship is about to stay together, to live together, to be together. But today, let me clarify that friendship is not only about whom we stay with. Friendship is about whom we follow and whom we attach with. In friendship, it's not necessary to stay together physically, but it's necessary to stay together mentally and emotionally. Arjun was not living with Lord Krishna in Dwarka. He was living in Hastinapur. Even though Arjun was following Lord Krishna, he was attached with Lord Krishna. Karna was not living with Duryodhan in Hastinapur. He was living in his Ang kingdom. But he was attached with Duryodhan. He was following Duryodhan. So the core part of friendship is about attachment and affection. Dear students, if you will touch a person who is infected by coronavirus, what will happen to you? All of you know very well that you also will get infected by coronavirus. That same coronaviruses will get transmitted to your body. Similarly, the friendship also is like an infection. If you will attach with good friends, automatically his good thoughts, good attitudes, good habits, good qualities will get transmitted to your life. If you will attach with the bad friends, automatically his bad thoughts, bad habits, bad attitudes, bad qualities will get transmitted to your life. Whom you attach with will determine that what kind of thoughts, attitudes, habits and qualities you will have in your life. Dear students, one more important thing about friendship, that in our life, friendship should be by choice, not by chance. Our friendship should be our choice. It should not be by chance. Dear students, do you know how friendship takes place in our life? When somebody helps us, we become his friend. When somebody favors us, we become his friends. When somebody praises us, that time also we like to be his friends. When we are influenced by his skills, his smartness, his appearance, his cleverness, we become his friends. Sometimes our second nature is matching with him, so we become his friends. And sometimes similarities, like similar class, similar school, similar native, similar all the things, that also will cause a friendship in our life. But these are not the reason to get attached with them. These are not the reason to follow them in our life. If somebody helps us, doesn't mean we should be his friend. You have to utilize your freedom to choose your friends. When Duryodhan helped Karna, Karna couldn't identify the selfish intention of Duryodhan. Why? Because Duryodhan praised Karna in front of everybody. Dear students, everybody likes self-praise. Self-praise is the sweetest sweet in the world. Everybody enjoy their self-praise. And did you ever notice? When we enjoy any sweet, when we enjoy the taste of sweet, our eyes will get closed. Did you ever notice? In the same way, when somebody is praising us, our eyes of knowledge will get closed. Afterwards, we cannot see the reality. We cannot understand the intention of that person. And afterwards, we have to become a victim of his selfish intention like a Karna. So my dear students, when somebody is praising you, be alert. Before you choose your friends, take some time to understand his intention, his like-dislikes, his inclination, his attitude, his aptitude, then you can make a choice of your friends. Dear students, now question is how to identify good friends and bad friends. So Bhagwan Swaminarayan said in Shikshapatri that one should avoid the company of six kinds of people. But before that, I hope you are watching this video session alone, along with your notepad. Now it's the time to check your friendship. So whoever are your friends, whoever the people stay around you, keep those all friends, all people in your mind. Whenever I explain these six kinds of bad friends, bad people, if any one of them is matching with these characteristics, you have to write down their names in your personal diary. So Bhagwan Swaminarayan said in Shikshapatri that chor papi vyasani naam sangah pakhandi naam tatha kami naam chana kartavyo jana vanchana karmana. These are the six kinds of bad people, bad friends. They are dangerous like coronavirus. How coronavirus can kill us? In the same way, these six kinds of people can kill our sanskar, our character, our spirituality. Now first one is thief. One who is stealing someone's things, one who is using someone's things without his permission, one who is selfish, who is greedy of money, avoid the company of such a thief person. One day he will betray to you also, he will make a loss to you also. Now second one is sinner. One who commits sin intentionally, one who has no regret, no shame, no guiltiness after committing sin, such person is called a sinner. If you will be with him, you also will become a part of his sinful activities. One day you also will become a sinner like him. Now third one is addict. One who is addicted to the alcohol, smoking, tobacco, drugs, media, mobile, TV, movies, etc. If you will be with such kind of addicted friends, then you also will get addicted to these all addictions. That is why I said you earlier, these all kinds of people are like coronavirus. If you will be with them, their addiction, their bad qualities, their bad habits will get transmitted to your life. Now fourth one is cheater. One who is speaking lie, who is playing game with his parents, elders, teachers, who is speaking something and doing something. If you will be with such cheater, one day you also will become a cheater. Now fifth one is vulgar. Who is speaking bad words, who is speaking vulgar words, who has vulgar attitudes for girls and women. Avoid such a vulgar person. If you will be with him, one day he will spoil your sanskar, he will spoil your character. Now sixth one is atheist. Who is this atheist? A person who doesn't believe in God, who doesn't believe in scriptures, who doesn't believe in pap and punya, who just believe in enjoying the worldly objects, worldly pleasures, such person is known as an atheist. If you will be in his company, you also will become faithless fellow like him. So my dear student, these are the six kinds of bad friends. Identify them and avoid them. But don't expose them. Don't expose them tomorrow that you are a cheater, you are a sinner, you are a vulgar, so I don't be with you. Don't create your enemies unnecessarily. Just stay away from them and be safe from them. That's it. Now you may be curious to know that who is called a true friend. Generally people say that a friend in need is a friend indeed. But today let me tell you, that's not true 100%. Because sometimes bad friends will help you in need to fulfill their selfish desires. Like how Duryodhan helped to Karna to fulfill his selfish desires. But today I will tell you the perfect definition of a true friend from Vachanamrutam. In Vachanamrutam, Bhagwan Swaminarayan said that true friend is one who tells you something for your betterment, even at the cost of hurting you, at the cost of displeasing you. One who stops you from going on the wrong path, even by hurting you, is called a true friend. Who cares your sanskar, who cares your success, your progress, your life, is called a true friend. on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, when Arjun said to Lord Krishna that I will not fight. At that time, Lord Krishna scolded Arjun. Klebhyam masma gama partha, netatva yupapadyate, shudram rade durbalyam tyaktotishta parantapa. Parth, don't be coward like Yunak. It doesn't befit to you. Give up your weaknesses and stand up for the fight. Lord Krishna said Arjun as Yunak. Important. Arjun was such a brave and mighty warrior. Who can tell him like this? Even though Lord Krishna scolded Arjun, why? Because Lord Krishna cares Arjun's life, Arjun's dharma. Now my question to you is, did you choose such a friend like Lord Krishna who can guide you at the each and every moment of your life? So my dear students, after watching this video, you have to write the names of two persons who can guide you at the each and every step of your life, whom you can share your problems, who can understand you, and who can guide you for the success and for the salvation. And one more important submission from Gurukul, that whenever you feel alone, you feel depressed in your life, remember, the door of Gurukul is always open for you. Blessings of Swamiji and guidelines of Swamiji will be always there with you. So my dear students, my dear Gurukulites, let's all of us choose such a right friend, raising friend like Lord Krishna in our life, and let's become victorious like Arjun. Thank you. Jai Swaminarayan.
Group. Today I'm going to tell you a story about a boy who sacrificed his life to save the train. Once there was a railway signalman who guarded and took care of the railway bridge. He lived in a hut close to the bridge with his 14-year-old son. The signalman spent most of his time inspecting and guarding the bridge and track. One day, a huge thunderstorm followed by a lot of heavy rain took place in the area that the signalman and his son lived in. As part of the signalman's everyday routine, he went to go check on the bridge and the track before the daily evening train came to cross the bridge. The signalman's son waited patiently for his father's return. When his father didn't come back, the son decided that he would go check on his father. So he followed his father's path and shouted for him. When the signalman's son reached the bridge, it was completely collapsed. Again, he shouted to his father, but there was no response. At the same time, the time for the evening train was coming quickly. The signalman's son thought to himself, if I do not do anything to stop the train, the passengers will be hurt because of the bridge. He quickly searched for a good place to stop the train by running along the track. He found a place where the train would pass through, although it was very hard to signal the train to stop, because the place that the boy wanted to stop the train was not wide. Suddenly, he had an idea. He thought, if I park a cart on the tracks and wave a red lantern while standing on the cart, the train driver will understand and will be able to stop the train before it reaches the bridge. He dragged the cart to the spot, parked it on the turn of the passage, and stood on the cart while waving the red lantern. Soon, he was able to hear the sound of the train coming. As the train came closer to the boy, the train driver saw the boy waving the red lanterns and decided to stop the train. He put on full brakes, but the train was still moving fast. The boy started shouting, "The bridge has collapsed! The bridge has collapsed!" The train sped and hit the cart, throwing the boy up and breaking his entire body. But thanks to the boy's hard work, the train was able to come to a full stop before it reached the fallen bridge. Knowing that the train hit the boy, everyone from inside the train rushed towards the boy to check on him. Unfortunately, they found him dead because the hit caused many injuries to the boy's head. The next day, the boy's body was buried with great honor, and his gravestone was engraved with age 14. He He sacrificed his life showing great courage and bravery that saved more than 200 passengers traveling on the train. The moral of this story is, the young boy sacrificed himself for the well-being of others. Let's hope that Sriji Maharaj blesses his soul. Jai Swaminarayan.